of traveler that likes to save on transportation expenses in order to splurge on fun things like experiences and hotels. So if you're like me, and if you're traveling to South Beach, Miami Beach, Miami, Florida, and if you want to know how to get to South Beach from Miami International Airport, and if you want to know how to get around on a budget, stay tuned, because I'm going to share with you my tips from my experience coming right up. Welcome back to my channel. At Frolic and Courage, I like to give you the practical tools, tips, and resources to help you do the things you want to do, like travel. So if you're looking to get around South Beach, Miami, Florida on a budget, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Click the subscribe button to subscribe to my channel, and let's get into the video. It's important to know where you are on a map if you're looking to go to South Beach. So we're going to take a look at that right now. South Beach is the southern portion of Miami Beach, which is located on this little teeny strip of island right over here. If we zoom out a little bit, we see that South Beach is just a small portion of Miami Beach, which is this whole strip right here. Miami encompasses all of this red area here. It's not technically part of Miami Beach, as we just saw. It's a separate entity. But when you talk about going to Miami, you are generally referring to this area, not Miami Beach. If we zoom out a little bit more, we'll see that South Beach, Miami Beach, Miami is all part of Miami-Dade County, which extends this entire area here. And if we zoom out, Miami-Dade County and Miami Beach and South Beach is on the southern tip of the state of Florida in the United States. And Florida expands from Pensacola all the way up top here down to Miami and Key West. And if we zoom out even further, we see that Florida is the southern tip or the southeastern tip of the United States of America. So how exactly do you go from Miami International Airport to South Beach or Miami Beach, Florida? There's a couple of different options, and I'm gonna show you which ones are the cheapest, most cost-effective ways to get there. I'm not gonna go over everything, just the cheapest ones, and you'll see why in a few moments. The first way is by purchasing an Easy Card. This little Easy Card has a 20-year lifespan, but it'll go inactive if you haven't used it for 12 months or more. If it's lost, there is a $2 fee, and if you register your card online, you can recoup all of your funds. The minimum load is about 10 bucks, but you can load a one-day pass for around $6 or load cash. You can also use a mobile payment. You don't have to use this card if you don't want to, because you can download the mobile app and pay with your phone, or you can use a contactless card to pay directly on the units. If you don't want to download the mobile app, which is available on iOS and Android systems, you can pick up one of these little cards at one of the machines outside of the bus station. Now listen to me very carefully here. The cheapest way to get from the Miami airport to South Beach is to take the Airport Express bus number 150 from the airport to South Beach. It only costs about $3 when you load that fare onto this card for a one-way trip. That is extremely cheap, because an Uber is gonna easily cost you between $20 and $40, depending on traffic, depending on surge charges, whatever. So at $3, plus the $2 fee, of course, for the card, so about $5 will get you to South Beach. Extremely affordable. Know that this Miami Beach Airport Express Bus 150 makes limited stops. This is the route from the airport station all the way to making these limited stops all along Miami Beach and South Beach. It runs about every 20 minutes from the following stops, 7 days a week, until about 11:30 p.m. So from about 6 a.m. or 5:10 a.m., depending on where you're being picked up, to 11:30 p.m. You also need to know that to get from the airport terminals, once you get off your plane, you're gonna have to take the MIA Mover tram, which is a free tram that'll take you directly to the bus terminals at the airport station. It's about a 10-minute tram ride, and you may have to walk for an additional 15 minutes. It is a pretty long walk to get to the bus terminals, but at that savings, you know, you want to stretch your legs anyways from sitting on a plane. So it's super cheap, super available for everyone. So check out the Metro Bus 150 to get from the airport to South Beach on a budget. From South Beach, you might have to walk about a block or two to get to your hotel depending on where it falls within those limited routes. So pack light, pack tight, and grab a bottle of water because it's a little hot outside. While you're actually on South Beach, there's a couple of ways that you can get around on a budget. The first is that there is a free trolley. Did you hear me? Did you hear me? I said a free trolley that goes back and forth between Miami Beach and South Beach specifically. There are four trolley lines that you can take. There is the South Beach Loop, the Middle Beach Loop, Collins Express, and the North Beach Loop. The trolley runs Monday through Saturday from 6 a.m. to midnight and Sundays from 8 a.m. to midnight. It is free and the frequency of service depends on your line. So for Middle Beach, it'll run every 15 minutes, whereas on the South Beach Loop via 11th Street, it takes and runs around 40 minutes. So know that you're gonna have to wait a little bit. These are all of the loops and transfer points that the trolley makes. And know that all of these maps are gonna be linked down in the description box below. So don't worry, don't try to pause the screen. You can go ahead and after the video, download it in the description box below. My next way to get around South Beach on a budget is to actually take an Uber. This was my preferred method, and especially since we decided to go outside of South Beach, we preferred Uber, specifically Uber Pool. It was the cheapest way to get around on a budget. We went back and forth to Bayside Marketplace and all around Miami to Little Havana, everything, for maybe about $9 or $10 a trip with Uber Pool. Of course, as you know, with Uber Pool, it picks up other passengers and you kind of split the fare, so it's not as expensive as getting just an Uber by yourself. But we found this to be a fast and efficient way because you cannot rely on the other forms of paid public transportation. Other than the bus and the trolleys that I mentioned, I really hate to break the bad news to you, but if you're looking to get around Miami on a budget using public transportation, I would not do that. I would not recommend that because the buses outside of the 150 Airport Express, they're unreliable, they don't come on time, they're often overcrowded. Don't waste your money or your time waiting on the bus. We did that and 40 minutes, okay? The bus was supposed to run every 20 minutes. 40 minutes rolled by with no bus. Everyone was hot, sweaty, and upset, and it never came. So we just called an Uber, which picked us up in less than 1 minute, and we went about our business. So I highly recommend taking an Uber or a Lyft or some other rideshare program. If you're gonna be in South Beach, if you're gonna be in Miami Beach, if you're gonna be in Miami and you wanna get around on a budget. If you're curious about the other forms of public transportation in Miami, like the Metro bus and the shuttle buses and the Metro rail fares, and you don't mind taking the risk that it may not be reliable, I'll go ahead and link this transit fares guide with all of the rules and regulations and transfer rates and passes and all that jazz down in the description box for your research below. Another way to save money on transportation in South Beach is to take a bike. There are public bikes that you can rent just using your credit card. Just go to any location on Miami Beach or South Beach, grab the bike, swipe your card, and you're good to go. There are some hotels, like our hotel, we stayed at Hotel Victor, so stay tuned for the room tour of that. But at Hotel Victor, they gave us free bikes, and by free, I mean it was part of the resort amenity fee, and that we could rent to go back and forth between South Beach, Miami Beach at our leisure. So check out your hotel amenities to see if that's something that they provide. Now, if you watched my What You Need to Know Before Going to South Beach and Miami Beach, Miami, Florida in general video, which I'll link at the end of this video or up in a card above, one of the things you know is at nighttime, people really like to show off with what they wear. Not only with what they wear, but with what they drive. Miami is a very see and be seen, a very bright, flashy, loud, you know, money is just flowing everywhere kind of a place. It also has its quiet moments too, don't get me wrong, but Ocean Drive, South Beach is a place where you want to show up and show off, show out. So if you want to stunt on a budget in Miami, I recommend using the Turo app. If you've never heard of Turo, and this is not sponsored by the way, so it was my hun's birthday, I wanted to surprise him with a little Miami stuntin' with his favorite car, but we rented a Mercedes-Benz S-Class from Turo, and it was significantly cheaper than trying to go to one of those luxury car rentals where you could easily pay up to $600 a day to rent a car. Ours was about $200 for 24 hours. We also bought some additional insurance because if you're going to rent from Turo and you're going to rent one of these luxury cars, one thing you need to do is to check with your insurance provider to see what's covered and what's not. I found out that looking at my personal insurance policy that it will cover rental cars that are valued $50,000 or less. So this Mercedes-Benz S-Class I rented was, I don't know, like $100,000 in value. So it didn't cover it. So I purchased a little bit of extra insurance for maybe like 10 or 11 bucks or something, or 20 bucks, something like that, with Turo, so that I can be covered in case there are any dings or anything like that. It doesn't cover the interiors, but it covers the exterior. And of course, no drinks, no food in the car. Come on now. Like, I don't want to pay that money. But it was a really inexpensive way for us to kind of, you know, make his birthday a little bit special by, you know, having Hun drive his favorite car. So if you want to go on Turo and check out the different cars that are available, that could be something you can do on a budget as well. In addition to like these great luxury cars, you can also rent any kind of car on Turo for less. Not only just, you know, the BMWs and the Maseratis, but you can rent, you know, Dodge Chargers, Fords, some kind of more basic cars too. So it's not just luxury. So if you want to get around on a budget on luxury or not, you can check out Turo, which is like the Airbnb of luxury car rentals. One thing to keep in mind though is if you're gonna rent out one of these luxury cars, parking can cost a lot in South Beach. It can be about $45 a day, sometimes cash only, sometimes more, sometimes less. Check with your specific hotel and see what those rates are before you book, so you're not out more. But if you want to stunt on a budget in South Beach, then check out Turo as an option. And there's also Enterprise and other rental companies, but definitely check out Turo. If you want to go outside of South Beach and explore Miami, stay tuned because my next video is going to be some things you can do in Miami. If you haven't already checked out my tips you need to know before traveling, go ahead and click the link in the description box below and after this video. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Subscribe to my channel. If you have comments, leave them down below and let me know what are you looking forward to in Miami and how are you going to get around on a budget. Share all of your tips, all your questions, everything in the comment section down below. I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.